I converted the SouthBend SB1001 lathe to CNC using LinuxCNC and a conversion kit from Billy Dirks. I made this control box. You have emergency stop, and then three buttons I control: start, stop, and pause, resume of your G-code. The interesting feature I think of this control box are these two MPG wheels. So this one controls the longitudinal feed, while this one controls the cross feed. So very similar to the manual wheels that were originally on here.
Two aluminum faces where the switches and the wheels attach to. And that is attached to a wooden box that clamps onto a stepper motor that's connected to the conversion kit. And that pushes up against a plate that's also on the conversion kit. The face plates will be milled on the CNC mill. And it starts with stock that is attached to a piece of MDF with double-sided tape. I started with a drill operation to do the outside holes, while the interior small holes were made by interpolating a 1/16th inch end mill. This is the first of the three push button holes as a bore operation, but the pitch is a little bit too fast. This is a 2D contouring operation at 40 inches a minute. The second plate is what will hold the emergency stop push button. If making these parts again, I would use a larger end mill to remove all of the material out of the center. 100 pulse per revolution MPG wheels. They have differential quadrature output, which means they can be used in a way that's immune to common mode noise, and that you can also achieve 400 pulses per revolution. However, the detents in the wheel limits where the wheel will be positioned, undermining the quadrature part of the MPG wheel. So because of the detents, 100 pulses per revolution is probably the effective maximum. I'll hold the emergency stop plate in place with epoxy. There are two more wooden parts that need to be made. This is the plate that goes onto the bottom of the box. Another nice feature about 2D contour is the option to mill both directions instead of only conventional or only climb milling. I added a pause resume button recently, and it's nice for situations like this. Hit pause resume, remove this piece which has come free, and then resume. You can see that plate that the stepper motor attaches to and the two socket head cap screws. The control box will press against that plate and will clamp onto the stepper motor. A few of the wooden pieces are screwed together in addition to being glued, such as the clamp that goes around the stepper motor. Horizontally, this is a clearance fit, while vertically is an interference fit. We use four screws underneath to pull down this clamp, squeezing the stepper motor. I know that doesn't sound like it would be very strong, but it actually is pretty rigid. I was going to use two Cat 6 cables, but I found this short piece of 16 conductor cabling. It's stranded wire, so I add ferrules to each conductor. I did wire up the differential return from the MPG wheels, but not all the connections require independent conductors. For example, the push buttons just need to bring three inputs on the Pico Systems Universal Stepper Controller to ground, so they share all the same ground as do the MPG wheels. The emergency stop, being part of a series circuit, does require two independent conductors. Technically, how the Pico Systems board works, one side of the emergency stop could be ground, and that could be the start of your emergency stop circuit, but that's not how I did it. I think this is a neat control panel, and I haven't seen anything like this on other do-it-yourself CNC conversions. The MPG wheels are essentially sending pulses, and I filter those slightly on LinuxCNC using a low-pass filter to smooth out the action. It's not perfect yet, and it's going to require some additional work, but it's usable. Each detent is half of a thousandth currently, and that gives me plenty of resolution. It'd be nice to use this as an example for open source controllers like LinuxCNC, but realistically this setup could be done on any controller with sufficient number of inputs and with a sufficiently high sampling rate on those inputs.